Hello friends, so we have been going through the various concepts such as ideal switches, characteristics of ideal switches, characteristics of practical switches and so many topics. In the previous video, we also saw the classification of power devices based on the application etc. So today we will see the control characteristics of power devices in a very broad fashion. Okay, so we can divide these power electronic devices based on the type of control what they have. Okay, so for example, the first one is an uncontrolled turn on and turn off. Okay, so these devices cannot be turned on or turned off in a controlled manner. See, whenever for example you are having a diode is an example for an uncontrolled turn on or turn off device. So this is a diode, right? So this is the anode, this is the cathode. So when you give a voltage such as the anode is positive with respect to cathode, the diode will conduct. But there are some devices where even if you provide the forward biasing and unless you give a specific gate signal, the device will not conduct. But however, in a diode, you know, or as in any semiconductor device, always for the device to turn on, there should be a forward biasing. Okay, so for always there should be forward biasing for a device to turn on. Okay, and once this forward biasing is there, there are some devices which will turn on instantly. Some devices you can control when they have to turn on. So that is the basis of this classification. Okay, so I'll write down that also here. So some devices can be controlled even if they are forward biased. Okay, so that is the basic idea. So a diode is a device in which there is uncontrolled turn on and turn off. See, when you are giving forward bias, the diode will conduct. When you are giving reverse bias, the diode will turn off automatically. You don't have to do anything. It is a natural property of the semiconductor. So, an example for uncontrolled turn on and turn off is the diode. Okay. So, the next one is the controlled turn on and uncontrolled turn off. Okay. So, in these devices, what happens is that you are given forward bias and you can control when you have to give the, when the device has to turn on by a particular method. Okay, that there are so many different types of methods, but however, the important thing is they can be turned on in a controlled manner, but the turn off is uncontrolled. That is, the moment you give reverse bias, the device will turn off. So turn on can be controlled, but turn off is uncontrolled. Okay, so an ideal example of this is a thyristor, which of course we will be learning in the future videos. So the ideal example is the thyristor. So it will turn on based on your wish, but once you give a forward reverse biasing, it will automatically turn off. You have no control over the turning off process. So the third classification is called control turn on and control turn off. Okay, so in these devices, what happens is that based upon the gate signal that you give, you can either turn on the device or you can turn off the device, irrespective of whether they are in the, see, for conduction, naturally they should be in forward bias condition, but for turning off, you can do that in the forward bias condition also. It need not be always in the reverse bias condition. So depending upon your requirement, you can control in a controlled manner, turn on and turn off device. So there are devices available which do this type of function also. That is control turn on and control turn off. Okay. So the examples for such devices are the bipolar junction transistors, the MOSFETs, IGBTs, gate turn off thyristors, then you have SIT, then you have MCT. There are so many devices like this. Okay, because these are not that important. We will mostly keep our discussion with MOSFETs, IGBTs, etc. So the next type of classification is a continuous gate signal requirement. So what these devices need is that to turn on these devices, you should continuously give a gate signal. Okay, so other than the forward biasing condition, for example, there is a gate signal here. So these devices need continuous gate signal. Okay, so for the device to turn on, you should have continuous gate signal. Okay, that is the basic idea. So this is continuous gate signal requirement. So these are some of the devices which come under this classification is BJT, then MOSFETs, IGBT, SIT, etc. So see, IGBTs, BJT, MOSFET and IGBTs, they also have controlled on, turn on and controlled turn off. However, for conduction, they need a continuous gate signal requirement also. We will see the characteristics in a very basic manner now, so it will be more clear. Then there are devices which have pulsed gate requirement. Pulsed gate requirement means If you give a pulse, that is enough to turn it on. You don't have to give a continuous signal. You give a pulse, it turns on the forward biasing condition, then you can remove the pulse because it will continue its action. Okay. So pulse gate requirement devices are SCRs or the thyristors. Then you are having GTO and you are having your MCT. Okay. Now there are some devices which have a rating, which is called bipolar voltage withstand capability. That is, they are having rating in the reverse direction as well as the forward direction. Okay. So some of the devices which have those ratings are SCR and GTO. We have seen this this the data sheet of SCR, remember, we already saw this. Then some devices have unipolar voltage withstand capability. Okay. So those devices are BJTs. So you never apply a reverse voltage to the BJTs, etc. You never apply a reverse voltage to devices like BJT. But you can apply a reverse voltage to devices like SCR because they are having a rating. They can withstand certain amount of voltage. Okay. So these don't have reverse voltage withstand capability. So that is BJT, MOSFETs, GTO, and IGBT. Now these are basic understanding. See, now till now we have not seen what is IGBT, what is MOSFETs and all. But that will come in the future. But this is an overall idea about various things. Ultimately, power electronic, any of this device is actually acting like a switch. Some are used in fast switching application, some are used in power switching application. That is the most of the difference. Okay, that also we will see in what application, what type of device is more suitable. Then some devices have bidirectional current capability. That is, it can allow current both in, see in this diode, the current can only move from left to right. But there are some devices where it will have the opposite current direction also. So these devices are the triacs and devices which are called RCTs. Okay, so these are, current can flow in this direction as well as the opposite direction. Unidirectional capability, naturally, most of the other devices are coming under unidirectional current capability. It will have only one side of conduction. So that is your SCR, MOSFET, BJT, any other device other than triac and RCT, IGBT, then your MCT, then your SCT, then your diodes. There are so many devices, I am not writing everything here, but let us keep it for just here. Now let us just understand what he meant by this control characteristics for various switches. Okay, so we'll start with the simple thyristor switch. Thyristor switch, or it is also called as an SCR. So SCR, we already saw, it is coming under two classification. One is control turn on and uncontrolled turn off. Other than that, it is also having pulse gate requirements. SCR was coming under controlled turn on, uncontrolled turn off, and the pulsed gate requirement, pulsed signal. It only requires a pulse signal. So we will draw a simple circuit here now. So this is the typical symbol of an SCR. Okay, so this is the anode, this is the cathode, this is the gate. And let us keep a simple load here. And let this Vs be the applied voltage. This Vs is the applied voltage. And here you can have the gate voltage. And here let us draw the output voltage V0. And this is some resistance R. So if you draw the graph for here, let us apply a DC signal. Okay, so we'll apply a simple DC signal. So your Vs is basically a DC signal. Okay, so anode is always positive with respect to cathode. Okay, anode is always positive with respect to cathode. That means this device is always forward bias. Okay, now let us draw the gate signal. So in the gate signal, we are going to give pulses because for this to turn on, a pulse signal is only required. So I'll give a pulse here. I will give a pulse like this, negative pulse, and this is a positive pulse. Okay, so I have already told you this is controlled turn on. So you can control when this device has to turn on. So that is the important condition. So we'll just remove this particular gate signal here so that we'll understand it more properly. So till this point here, you see, so this is the gate signal and this is the output voltage. So unless the device is going to start to conduct, V0, see, if SCR is on here, so this Vs will be equal to V0 because it will be like a closed switch. V0 will be equal to Vs. So when SCR is off, the SCR is off, V naught will be equal to 0. That is the basic idea. So from 0 to, let us call this as T1. From 0 to T1, you see the diode is for the device is forward biased, but however I have not given any gate signal. So that means from 0 to T1, the voltage V naught will be equal to 0. Voltage V naught will be equal to 0 because the SCR is turned off. So it is 0 here. But at T1, I am giving a signal. T1, I am giving it a gate pulse. Remember that it's a gate pulse. So at that point, SCR will turn on and V naught will be equal to Vs. So V naught will be equal to Vs. Okay. So it will continue like this. Now here I am giving a negative signal. But you know that it is uncontrolled turn off. Okay. So till this for, once the SCR turned on, and if you have maintained forward biasing condition, you cannot turn it off. Okay. So you continue like this. Here I am giving another signal, but it will not make any difference. So it will continue to move like this. So to turn off this SCR, you have to give a reverse bias signal. So after some time, if you give a reverse signal like this, at this point of time, if you give a reverse signal, that is minus Vs, the device will turn off. After this point, the device will like turn off here. Okay. So that is the basic idea of a thyristor. So for the second classification, or to second control characteristic, we'll take a device which is called as GTU. It is also called as a gate turn off type of a thyristor. It is also called as a gate turn off type of a thyristor. That means you can control when the device is going to turn on, as well as you can control when the device is going to turn off. Okay. So usually the device is turned on using a, for example, a positive gate pulse, and the device is turned off using a negative gate pulse. So the device like GTO, which is coming under controlled turn on and turn off characteristics. Okay, there are so many other devices like GTO, MTO, then IGCT, SITH, all these switches are coming under the same type of classification, under control turn on and control turn off. Okay, so now let us draw a simple circuit with the GTO. So we'll quickly draw the symbol here. So symbol roughly looks like this. So this just shows that it is a gate turn off, or it has a control turn on and turn off characteristic. Okay, so here you are having an anode, cathode, and this is the gate side. Okay, and here you are applying the voltage Vs. And here you are having a load R, and this is a voltage V naught. Okay. So what I have told you about this device has a controlled turn on and controlled turn off. Okay. So we'll just start by drawing the, in power electronics, I already told you, drawing waveforms is going to be very important. That is why I am drawing these waveforms now. Although we have not started to see these devices, but however, you should have a habit of drawing these waveforms. Okay, so it has control turn on and control turn off. That means a positive signal turns on, okay, and the negative signal turn off. Negative signal is going to turn off. Okay, and when the device is turned on, V naught is equal to Vs, and when the device is turned off, V naught is equal to 0. So these are all the information that we need. So this is Vs, this is the gate signal, and this is the V naught output voltage. Okay, so again here also we will take a constant DC voltage to simplify our explanation, and let us give a gate signal. So I am giving a gate, positive gate signal here, and after some time maybe I will give a negative gate signal, and then after some time I am going to give a positive gate signal. Okay, so when positive gate signal is, so before that let us assume that the device was turned off. Before this T1, let us assume that the device is turned off. Okay, and this is T2 and this is T3. Okay, three time intervals that we are taking here. So before T1, let us assume that the device is turned off. That means when the device is turned off, V naught is equal to 0. Okay, now at T1 you are turning on the device and it is forward bias. At T1 you are turning on the device using a positive gate signal, and so what will happen once the device is turned on? V naught is equal to Vs. So here V naught is equal to 0. And after some time you are giving a negative gate signal. So when you give a negative gate signal, the device is turned off and V naught will become equal to 0. So here V naught is equal to Vs. At this point it is turned off. okay, and it will continue like this. V naught is equal to 0. At T3, again it is turned on. Okay, that means V naught will be equal to Vs. V naught will be equal to Vs. Okay, so that is the basic idea of a control turn on and control turn off type of a device. Okay, now let us move to a third type of device which is very important for us, which is the transistor switch. Transistor switch. Okay, so let us see what is the transistor in sense BJT. So let us see BJT. So BJT is coming under control turn on and turn off. Okay, also it requires, BJT requires continuous gate signal requirement. It requires continuous gate signal requirement. So that is the two conditions that you have to be careful about. Okay, so now let us draw for a BJT transistor switch. Okay, I will draw a simple circuit here. So this is your collector, this is your base, and this is your emitter. This is a simple NPN type of a transistor. Emitter, and this is your Vs, Vs voltage, and let this be your V naught. This is a resistance R, and here you are giving the gate signal. Here you are giving the gate signal, or in analog electronics, you might have been telling this as the base voltage, right? Base voltage, base current, etc. Okay, so for the transistor switch, how it will work? It has continuous gate signal requirement. Continuous gate signal requirement. It has controlled turn on, and controlled turn off. Okay, controlled turn on and controlled turn off. Okay, so we will see how we are going to draw this type of signal. So again, I will write, when the device is turned on, when the device is turned on, V naught will be equal to Vs, and when the device is turned off, any device in this case, V naught will be equal to 0. These two conditions are requirement. And to turn on the device, you need continuous gate signal. Okay, that means the gate signal should not be equal to 0. You need continuous gate signal. So we will see what does that actually mean. So here you are having your Vs, and here you are having your Vg, or you can also call it as base current. Ig also you can write it here, that's not an issue. I am calling it as Vg because that is what the textbook was calling it. So that we are having some kind of a uniformity. So here again I am, Vs is again a DC signal. Vs is again a DC signal here, and Vg is going to be a continuous gate signal. Okay, here in these devices you have pulsed gate signal. Okay, because these are, GTO is a pulsed device. Here but you need continuous gate signal. So I will draw a continuous gate signal like this, and from here I will stop. And after some time I will again start like this. Okay, I will not take it from here, because let us take it from somewhere here. So this is the gate signal I am going to give. So here you can see it is a continuous, this area is continuous. Don't think that this, don't take it as a total value. From here to here continuously I am giving a gate signal. From here to here I am giving continuously a gate signal. So that is the basic idea. A pulse is like this, right? This is a pulse. But a continuous gate signal is more of like this. Okay. So now let us see. Now if you see in this particular graph, from 0 to T1, although the voltage is positive, I have not given any gate signal. So if I have not given gate signal, the device is turned off. The device is turned off, and V naught will be equal to 0 in this case. So from 0 to T1, the device will be turned off. So here V naught is equal to 0 here. From T1 to T2, I have given a continuous gate signal. So Vg is not equal to 0 and the device is turned on. Device is turned on, so V naught is equal to Vs. V naught is the output voltage. So from here to here it's like this. Now for an SCR, it doesn't matter. Once you turn off, whatever you do, the signal, the device will be turned on till you reverse bias the device. But here, even if you but here what happens is that if you bring the voltage or bring the gate signal to zero, if you bring the gate signal to zero, what happens in a transistor is the device turns off. Okay, here from T2 the gate signal is becoming zero, and therefore the output also becomes zero because the device turns off, because the device turns off like this. T3 what is happening? Again I am giving the gate signal, again the device will turn on and the output voltage will be equal to Vs. So V naught is equal to Vs, V naught is equal to 0, V naught is equal to Vs. Okay, so this is a basic transistor switch. Okay, so similarly, very similar graph you can draw for devices which are MOSFETs also. Okay, so we will draw a quick MOSFET circuit here. So I will just draw the device first. Okay, So this is a MOSFET symbol actually, a little bit complicated as compared to your simple BJT, IGBT, etc. So this is your gate signal. So this is your gate voltage VGS. So this is called drain. This is called source. Okay, just like you are having collector, base and emitter, you are having your drain, source and gate. So here you apply the voltage like this. Okay, so this is your applied voltage VS. Okay, and here you are having your load. So this is your load. Okay, so this is your applied voltage VS and this is your gate signal, and here you are having your load, and we'll call this voltage as V naught. Okay, so MOSFETs or IGBTs, MOSFET, this is a MOSFET circuit, this is a MOSFET circuit, and then I can also draw an IGBT. So this is the gate and this is a symbol of a IGBT. Okay, so these both have similar characteristics. So these are also having continuous gate signal requirement. So this MOSFET also has continuous gate signal requirement, and they also are the control turn on and control turn off. That is, if you give gate signal, you will get voltage. If you don't give gate signal, you will be turning off the voltage. Okay, so it's very similar characteristics. We'll draw it quickly. Therefore, so this is T, VS, and this is your VGS, gate to source voltage, and here you are having your V naught. Okay, so this is your VS here, positive voltage, positive bias, and let us draw the gate signals. So I'll just draw it like this. So from T1, T2, T3, so 0 to T1, you can see the device will be turned off because the gate signal is 0. T1 to T2, because there is gate signal, the device will be turned on. T2 to T3, you can see again there is no gate signal, the device will be turned off. Okay, and when the device is turned off, V0 is equal to 0. When the device is turned on, V0 is equal to VS. Device is turned, T2 to T3, device is turned off, again 0, again positive. Okay, so these are characteristics which cover almost all type of devices. Okay, so for a diode, you know, if you give forward bias, it will turn on. If you give reverse bias, it turned on. Okay, whereas in thyristors, you saw that they are having pulse gate requirement. That means once you give the signal, it will turn on. Okay, but you cannot turn it off if you give a negative signal and the voltage is forward biased. You can turn it off only if you give a reverse biasing signal for a thyristor. Then you saw that there are devices like the gate turn off thyristors which are having only pulsed gate signal requirement, but however they can be turned on and turned off in a controlled manner. So if you give positive signal, it will turn off, turn on. If you give negative signal, it will turn. Okay, for the same forward biasing condition. Then you saw MOSFETs and BJTs, IGBTs. These type of devices require continuous gate signal requirement. Okay, so as long as the gate signal is there, it will keep on working. Once you remove the gate signal, even if the forward biasing condition is activated, it will turn off. Okay, so these are continuous gate signal requirement. So that is the difference between the MOSFETs, BJTs and the thyristors. In MOSFET, BJTs, IGBTs, etc., you are having continuous gate signal requirement. Whereas in a BJT, sorry, in a SCR or a thyristor, you have only pulsed requirement. Okay, in GT also you are having only a pulsed requirement. Okay, so these have advantages, disadvantages, etc. In the next video, we will just see in the commercial industry for different power ratings, what type of devices that can be used. Okay, out of all these devices available, what are usually used in commercial industries. Okay, so till I see in the next video, it's me Varun signing off, and have a great day. Thank you.
Now that the video is over, please stay with me for 30 more seconds. Now the vision of this channel is to create a repository of good quality videos with crystal clear explanation regarding various topics related to electrical engineering. Now if you want to help me spread the word, please share this video with anyone interested in these topics. The second thing is that for me, education is a two-way process. Therefore, if you have any doubts or suggestions regarding any of the videos or regarding the channel, please put them in the comments below. We can have a healthy discussion, and that way we can build a strong community of electrical engineers. So that's it for today's video. So till I see you in the next time, it's me Varun signing off, and have a great day. Thank you.